G'day everyone and welcome back to Nat's Knackers Yard. I'll be Nat and this will be my Knackers Yard. This will be my diversion, Dave. This will be my Phaser 600 Rat Boy. That's a Kafka version complete with a rear end change as well. And this is my other Phaser. And what you are also seeing is test footage, I suppose. I've got a new phone. I've got an old phone, new to me. I've got a OnePlus A6. I was looking for an A5 under recommendation from Charlie, amongst others. This one was cheaper, mostly because it's got a broken back. The glass on the back is broken, but it's fine with the case on, and frankly, this is all I use it for, so why wouldn't I? Let me know what you think of the video and the sound. It was mostly the sound that was concerning with my Nokia. I kept getting a crackle. I routinely tried to cut it out and edit it out, but I quite often missed it. And hopefully that won't happen on this. So what I'm going to try and do here is sort out this firing on three, because really hot on those ones. I have done a bit of blind balancing, i.e. just adjusting the screw with no meters on it, no nothing, and I have managed to get it hot. So I'm proving that I can get something through there. I just want to give it a quick balance and see what happens. Now, I don't have, Charlie has very kindly offered his carb balancers, because I do want to buy some decent liquid ones, and he's going to let me have a go with his, but I haven't got those yet, I haven't sorted it out. So I'm going to have a go with my manometers and see how I get on. So let's go. Right, as much as I don't like using these, I've checked to, I know that one's knackered. I'll get no response from it at all. I think that one's okay. These two seem fine, so I'll do it in pairs still. I will clean out my manometer, but it's all gone a bit rotten. It needs a good douche. Right, so let's give it a go. Right, I think the screwdriver was too broad, so it wasn't turning, it wasn't catching. I think I'm in. Let's try again. Some heat off that left one again. So let's do 3 and 4. Right, so I think I'm there. This is by far the most, I'm no expert at car balancing, but I've done a few, and this is by far the most awkward balancing screws to get to by a long way. So the screwdriver needs to be really narrow, but it needs to be enough to get there and to get the bite on the end. Right, let's give this a go. You might be in a better position to see. I'm going to have to do it from your side, probably stood in front of the camera. But it's the only way I'm going to see. Try turning the ignition on first, Nat, you idiot. I'm not going to touch those. Right, I'm happy with that. Right, so I'm going to go 1 and 4 next to balance the two banks together. Right, so that's set up there. A lot easier to do the two banks because fundamentally the screw's easier to get hold of. Right, so I've got them pointed roughly in the right place with no pressure. Got my ignition on, holding the screw so it doesn't do. There's only one way of really checking whether or not it rides any better, and that's to ride it. So let's just whip this bad boy around the block. I say this bad boy, I'm giving him a name yet. Oh, hang on, before I whip that round the block, let's try whipping the tank back on, shall we? Be a bit embarrassing if that fell off. gonna be a bit painful because I'd follow it. Still got to do the speedo, chasing some dodgy wiring. I hope that's all it is. I think that's all it is. Very strange experience going backwards on a bike. Right. Good enough for me for now.
This is going to get MOT'd on the weekend if I can find the time.
Right, so there we go. Still a bit cool on one. I was numbering them wrong then. So on carb one, it's still a bit cool. I do wonder if a blast will cure it, frankly. I kind of get the feeling it will. I now know it's balanced correctly. A little bit of arsing around on carb balancing, but one and two were out. Three and four were fine, and the balance, the overarching balance, was close. No, it was close, but a little bit of fettling. It's just pulled it back a bit better. Right, happy with that. That'll do for now. It's going to be MOT this weekend. Things I still want to do, I want to take that off and paint it. I'm going to have to take the whole lot off to do that. I need to sort out that speedo. It's not for MOT, it's just for my own safety more than anything else, because this goes quite quickly if you're not concentrating. Two questions for you, I suppose, people. One, how's the camera? Is it any better? Is it any different? Or is it exactly the same? And two, what do I call this? I don't like having bikes that haven't got names. And this is currently the bike with no name. Thanks very much, all. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Stay tuned and we'll see how we get on. The next one might be the MOT run. I don't think I'm going to ban this. I'm going to day insurance it and hoik it up there. Brill. Cheers, all. Catch you later. Right, so maybe this is the culprit on the old speedo. I've got a loose wire. Now what I'm trying to do is just track its length and the ends of any others to see if I can work out what it's come off, what it's loose from. Failing that, I'm going to be on Tinchernet trying to find the wiring diagram, which ain't going to be fun. Let's give it a go. Think I found it, chaps and chapesses. There was a dodgy connection between these ones here, as in when I took the tape off it just fell apart. look at that, 84,000, oh no, 8,400, yeah, okay. Right, so let's get those properly terminated, wrapped up. I'll do a bit of tidying up around here and get that done. Right, there you go, and that is me for the evening. Tidied up, a bit of black tape kicking around there, and I now have a speedo. What a way to finish a day. Now I think what I'm going to do is unplug the ignition from the bock here, which from my previous knowledge of my last one teaches me that it's those two. Unplug, feed through, get it in position where I'm going to leave it, and then unbolt, and then that gives me couple of days of arsing around to get that stripped, painted and back on. Cheers all, catch you later.